All right, so the very first thing I'm gonna look at here is a leather speed bag by Everlast. This is basically good for speed bag training and reflex training. It's a pretty nice build. You're pretty much just paying for the shape of it and the actual leather build quality. This is the actual original bag that I got with the kit like 6 years ago. The bag itself is really cheap, to be honest. The biggest problem with that other bag is, first of all, the shape is more of a ball shape. Now, between that, having a cheaper setup, and having those white pinstripes that pretty much kind of protrude from the edges, I had a very tough time having a constant or steady bounce back. So the next thing you're going to see here is the new Cotter Pin. Now this is built extremely nice, it's stainless steel. Now one thing you will notice is there's four screws here. On a higher end bores, the screw holes go all the way through and there's like a nut on top. Now this particular one that I have here, it only came with screws and it doesn't even screw all the way through the bore. But the great thing is I wasn't sure until I took it home, the actual four holes line perfectly with what originally had that's made of plastic. Now screwing it in, it feels like it's secure, it feels like it's not gonna go anywhere. But for any reason, if it started to break loose from the board, for any reason, which I doubt, but if it does, all you have to do is basically unscrew those screws, get a drill bit that's not bigger, but pretty much just push the holes all the way through, and then it should be big enough for the screws that came with this screw from the top of the board, so basically it's never going anywhere. So as you can see here, this is the factory one, it's very cheap. Not only because it's plastic, but this little plastic ball in here, in the beginning when I first used to hit this thing, and basically when if you miss and you don't do it correctly, the bag will buckle. I have sensitive ears already, but the noise is so loud and like a clanking sound that it just killed my ears. You'll see me hitting the bag in the background here. Don't judge me because I mean, like I said, I haven't hit this thing in like 6 years. But me just hitting it in a constant, slow tempo, you'll notice that, you know, you can tell just by looking at it, it's not going anywhere. The only thing that's shaking is the actual unit itself. And as you can see here, look at that top piece of right wood. It's pretty much kind of shaking back and forth. And that's because it's not in the studs anymore. That's the only reason it's shaking this hard. If this was helpful at all, please hit like and subscribe. For more information, please visit www.howtoandreviews.com. Till next time.